In this tutorial, I'm focusing on a plugin that Blender users are likely to come across, the Plant Library, a nature pack. It's a completely free plugin with incredibly detailed models that you can use when you want to add a natural touch to your 3D projects. I will show you the basic logic of using the plugin step by step. But first, let's see how to download and activate the plugin. This is the page for the Plant Library plugin. I will leave a link to it in the description section. When you go to this page, you need to register and log in to the Blender market. You can do this for free. If you are working with a lower Blender version than the value written here, this plugin may work problematically. Therefore, you need to pay attention to the minimum Blender version. After logging in, click on the Purchase button, already for $0. It is also stated here that it is free. I click on the Purchase button. It is added to the cart. Then I click the View button and you will come to a page like this. By clicking the Continue to Checkout button, you will become the owner of this product by clicking the Complete Order button. This is how the purchase process is done on this site. And because it was $0, we didn't have to pay any fees. After adding this product to our list, that is, after purchasing it, you will see some links that we can download this way. Depending on the rendering engine you use in Blender, you can download it here. If you are using Octane, you need to download this. If you are using Cycles or Eevee, which are Blender's default rendering options, you need to download this. I click on this and I download this file to my computer, to my desktop. The file is over 700 megabytes in size. It is downloaded. I open the file from where it is downloaded and I drag it into this folder. This is the file. And this is what came out of the file. It is a RAR file, so you can decompress it with any compression program. Look here is a file with the Blend extension. Blend is the extension of Blender. When I open this file by double clicking on it, you will see a project file listing all the plants in this file. See, these are actually the plants we will use. You can examine them in the way. We will not use this method because we want to use it as an asset and not in the project file. Look just like here. I'm closing this file. I'm opening a new file in Blender. First, let me show you how to use the asset part. It is already very easy. I copy the address of the folder where we downloaded and extracted the files. Ctrl+C. Now at this point, we open Blender. Select the Preferences option under Edit. Here you will see file paths at the bottom among the options on the left. I click on File Paths. Let's expand this page a little bit more. Because in this window, we will use the Asset Libraries section. I click on the plus icon on the right side, paste the address I copied here, and click on Enter. Then you can click on the Add Asset Library button. The folder we defined will come here. If you wish, you can double click on it and change the name if it has an inappropriate name. I'm changing it to Plant Library. Click on the menu icon at the bottom left. By selecting the Save Preferences option, we will not have to do this process over and over again in future Blender projects. This saves the process we have done. We can close this window. Below you will see the timeline area. Since we don't need timeline in our project right now, I want to change this field with Asset Browser. I click on the icon on the top left and select Asset Browser to change this window. And I change the All option here and select Plant Library so that the plants we have just installed will appear here as assets. Therefore, we will be able to drag and drop these assets to the scene and use them in this way. You can expand this screen using Ctrl Space key combinations and have a better look at what is inside. Leaves, plants, even floor textures are available here. You can also filter by clicking on the folders on the left. Look, I filtered flowers and it only showed me the options with flowers. It is showing the grass right now. I can see categorized files like filter plants, filter stones, etc. all at once. Let's go back to the previous view by pressing Ctrl Space again. Let's do an example right away after bringing the assets here. I have deleted all the objects on the scene. And I'm creating a new plane, making it a little bit bigger. When we come to the material section, you can see the floors in the materials. The floors in the material folder here. We can drag it directly onto the ground to see what effect it creates. But shading needs to be selected here. Look, it looks like this. Or if I select this, it will look like this. We can't clearly see how it looks right now because there is no light. Let's quickly set up a lighting system in the scene. Let's select Cycles as a render, and I'm going to World Properties and click on the icon next to color. Then select Sky Texture, and we can set the sun intensity to 0.1 and the strength to 0.5. If you think it is too bright or too dark, you can edit these values. I couldn't make the sun intensity value 0.1, now I did. I want to leave it at 0.2. Now let's add some plants to the scene and see how they are used. I'm adding this to the scene and dragging it like this. What we are going to do is, I need to add them to a collection. I press the letter M on the keyboard, I select new collection, and then let's give it a name. I type plants and click OK. And look, if you look at the list on the right, it is plants. We can see that the plant is under the plants collection. Now I select the ground and go to the particle properties panel. I add a new particle by clicking on the plus icon. Here we first select hair, then we select the advanced option. Let's scroll down in the section, I'm opening render. Let's change the render as option to collection and change the collection value to plants, which we just named. When we do all these operations, we will start to see plants on the scene. If the size is too small, you can resize these plants by changing the scale value, and thus we have added the first plant to the ground. Now let's try a new object in addition to this. For example, let's add a dry plant. I put it here. To transfer this plant to the floor, as before, I press the letter M on the keyboard again, and then I select the plant's collection we just created. As soon as we add it to this collection, we will automatically see this plant on the floor. Let's add a flower. Again, I drag the flower here. I press the letter M, add it to the collection, and this time you will be able to see the flowers on the scene. If you want to change the number of these plants, you can change the number value in the Particle Properties tab. Instead of 1000, let's make it 2000. Let's set it to be twice that. As you can see, it also affected the ground. If the plants are too small compared to the ground, we need to change the scale value as I just mentioned. For example, I will make it 0.4. Look, it has grown a lot, even too much. Let's change it to 0.2. Of course, at the same time, because there are so many of them, it looks like they overlap. 0.2 looks good. Now let's sprinkle in some rocks. I go to the rocks folder, select one of these. We have already learned how to include it in the ground. I press the letter M, I select the plants folder, and then we start to see some rocks among these plants. Even when we look very closely, we can see that it gives a very high quality result. In this way, we can easily add what we want to add on certain grounds. I reduced the emission value from 2000 to 500 so that it would be a little bit less sparse and less tiring for the computer. And notice that all the plants are the same size. We can make them a little bit randomly scattered. We need to change the scale randomness value under the scale value. Let's make it 0.2. So there will be a little difference between the sizes. This can add a bit of realism to the scene. If the axis of the object you add on the scene are different, we will change them as follows. For example, let's look at this flower model. The flowers look normal here, but it can also look like this. I'm going to break it, and I'm going to show you how to fix it. First of all, select Origin under Options, then rotate these origins on the axis you want by pressing the letter R on the keyboard. See, when I rotate this, the result will be wrong. You will see that the flowers disappear because of the axis change. But if I move the Z axis up, it will look normal like this. So it will look right. This is how to use the Plant Library plugin. As you can see, we can easily create a single collection and quickly place the plants in the collection on the ground. But don't think of it as a background. You can also add on other objects. Let's add a cube on the scene and see how this collection looks on the cube. I remove the origin. Let's assign the same collection to the cube object we just added. I click on the plus icon. A new particle has been created, but the particle we just created is here. When I selected it, it quickly integrated it into the cube we added. We can also change the background of this cube. We can add material on the white sides like we did on the floor. I'm creating a new cube, and I'm going to shove this on the new cube. And when I move the cube forward a little bit and make it smaller, open the asset library. Go to the material folder and drag one of the materials here onto the cube. As you can see, it has taken the image of the material. Now we are going to create a new particle. But we will use the particle we just created. This time we have added the plants from the collection here to the cube. And the cube now has a base. In this tutorial, I showed how the plant library plugin, a free plugin, can be used on floors, on projects with plants in the environment. As you can see, we did it in a quality and practical way. That's it for this video. I hope it was useful. If today's video was useful to you, don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel right now. Just click on the subscribe button below this video. Thank you for watching.